This is the game I have been waiting for. I'm sure a lot of people agree. They were waiting for Oswalt to take the mound, man. I was just waiting, man. I was honestly thinking just going into a game against the CPU and seeing how well he is, because I haven't even pitched with him once. Not once against anyone, against the CPU or anything. So this is legit the Roy Oswalt debut. This is the first time he has taken the hill in the Sandlot jersey. This is the first time Oswalt has taken the mound. So I was hoping I could get a good performance, which is what I usually hope for when I get a debut game on the mound. But, you know, Oswalt, man, it just seems like, I feel like I just look at those stats and I was just thinking, it looks like a pretty nasty card. I've heard some people say they've used him and they haven't done so well with him at first, I guess. But 79 velocity, 79 break with someone with a sinker, 79 velocity with someone with a sinker could be all right. 79 break may not be the best, because Hershiser, man, he has like, what is his break? Is it in the 90s? I forget what it is, but who else said it? I'm pretty sure it was Mighty. Mighty also said that Hershiser is, it was one of his videos, I'm pretty sure, one of his streams, I think. He also said that Hershiser is a difficult pitcher to hit in the game, and I completely agree, man. It seems like that's the case. It seems maybe not difficult, but it just seems like not many people can get much going against him. And I completely agree. It seems like that's the case. And every single time I've taken the mound with Hershiser, it seems like no one can do anything against him. And I faced him, when was it, a couple games ago, I'm pretty sure, only got 4 hits through like 8 innings. And then I'm pretty sure Buddy went to the pen, and that's when the bats started to get going. I'm pretty sure that's exactly what happened. Wasn't able to get much going against Hershiser, and then once he put somebody in from the pen, that's when the bats broke free pretty much. But again, just like in the previous game, the offense was getting going early in this game. Revere, dude. Ben Revere might be the most underrated card in the game. He gets things going with the single, or the double to left field, actually, and then Brantley follows that up with an RBI single up the gut, and then Arenado. Maybe he can start to heat up yet again like he was doing in the past couple of months. So Victor Martinez, he hasn't really got much going since he's joined the squad. And right there, you would have thought would have been an inning-ending double play, but he's not able to make the throw over to first base. That is crucial, man, because I'm getting another run in. Ripken wasn't able to make a solid swing on that, was kind of late, so he's making that grab just at the edge of the warning track. But I do get 2 runs, so that is good for Oswalt, man. Just get the lead. Hopefully I can maintain the lead the rest of the game, or just until, you know, the late innings or something, and the pen can take over. But this guy's getting off to a good start in this inning, ripping a double right over the head of Lou Brock. Wasn't able to make the grab, so he is threatening. I don't know why this guy did this. I mean, honest to God, he has, you know, half decent speed on second base. I'm pretty sure that was Melvin Upton Jr., the flashback BJ Upton, which is, I think it was the best card he had in his lineup. He decides to lay down a bunt, and then he's getting tagged out trying to get to third base, which I knew he was going to do. I mean, obviously, maybe try to get the bunt over to the first base side, which actually, you know what he tried to do? He probably tried to get the bunt down to the third baseman, just didn't try to get the a solid bunt down, so it was just like a little, you know, dribbler up the third baseline, so it wasn't so hard hit. So then no one would have been covering third base, but still, man, you got to, I don't know, I wouldn't have done that. I mean, there was nobody down, right? Like, that's the thing. I wouldn't have done that with nobody down 100% with Melvin Upton up at the dish, his best player most likely. So this guy was able to score a run, but wasn't able to get a couple runs. So that's still good, man. Still have the lead. Francisco Lindor is getting things started off in this inning with a double down the right field line. So Lou Brock, you guys hear me saying in the previous videos, he has been on a roll, man. He has been. Every single game he's played since he's been in, he's been putting up multi-hits. That's another base hit, another RBI for Lou Brock. I dropped him down in the lineup just to try and get that speed down there. Look at Revere, dude. Revere getting another single and an RBI in the process. Revere, 2 for 2 on the day, and I wasn't stopping. I was going to try and get as many hits as I could with Revere, to show that he is underrated, because, yeah, man, I looked at his stats. I still haven't shown his stats yet. I think he has, like, 82 contact versus righties. Against lefties, man, his contact versus lefties is, like, high 90s, I'm pretty sure, so he has better contact versus lefties. But 82 contact versus righties, with like high 90s vision is very good. So this Ben Revere card may stay in the lineup for a little bit, even though he is a silver and a lot of people probably want to see diamonds and golds. If Ben Revere is just continuing doing what he's doing, I don't see any point of taking him out, really. Like, why would I take him out if he's just doing damage at the dish every single game? So this guy was able to get a bloop single with D. Gordon, and then a couple batters later, he's just grounding one right back to Oswalt, and he's making another crucial mistake on the bases, man. I'm getting him in a pickle in between third base and home, and I'm tagging him out once again. So this guy, man, he could have possibly, you know, I guess not had the lead, but this game could have been, you know, maybe tied within one run at least. If this guy wasn't making some crucial mistakes on the base paths, if I can speak correctly on the bases, if he wasn't making some mistakes, he could have been in this game much more than he was. I'm getting a K right there with Oswalt. I think that was his like second of the game. But next guy coming to the plate is Correa, and that's ugly, dude. You can't be leaving sinkers right over the middle of the plate. That was a definite mistake, 100%. You know I wasn't trying to do that. So he is back within two. So Melvin Upton is back up, and this is what I was saying. I would have been swinging the bat with him because he's ripping a double over Lou Brock's head once again. Lou Brock not able to make the grab with 99 speed. I mean, his fielding isn't really there, so I guess it's understandable. But he did have two guys on. I think I walked the next guy, and then Gary Sanchez is just flying out in foul territory to end that inning. So Lou Brock is back up, and look at Lou Brock once again, man. He is sending one pretty deep, not able to leave the yard, but should have possibly tested going for three. I did make a bad decision a couple games ago trying to get Lou Brock over to third base with nobody down, and then I got thrown out. And Ben Revere steps up to the dish for his third at-bat of this game, and he is ripping a triple to the left center gap. So 3 for 3 on the day for Revere. I mean, what else can you say, man? It hasn't been too many games so far. I understand that, but still, Revere has been swinging a really good bat. Always making solid swings with Revere, so I'm, you know, squaring stuff up a lot. Brantley was able to square something up right there, but unfortunately, he is making a pretty decent grab over there at second base. Wasn't able to get another RBI for Brantley in this game. Arenado is back up. Check, swing, puts that in play. He's making the play, so wasn't able to score that run, Revere from third base, but I still have a lead as I got another insurance run in from that Revere triple. So man, like, leadoff hitter, the prototypical leadoff hitter is that Ben Revere, good speed and all that stuff. So this guy is getting off to another good start, man. This guy was actually making a lot of good swings against Oswalt. Just, you know, he was just making some boneheaded mistakes on the bases. He gets another single up the gut, so it's one down. Starling Marte is in. He was taken off on the pitch. I didn't even realize it. And then I'm getting caught with my pants down, man. This guy is able to get into first base. So now Victor Martinez is in. One swing of the bat could tie this game up. He's hitting a ground ball to Ripken. And that is an inning-ending double play. That's huge. Oswalt gets out of it, so I was going to continue the game with Oswalt, man. Like I was saying in the previous game when Scherzer was making the debut, I want to go as long as I could without just all hell breaking loose against the pitcher making the debut. So it is the bottom of the fifth inning, which is, it's all right, man. I was planning on getting to at least the sixth with Oswalt in this game. And Victor Martinez, as I was saying, hasn't done too much for the squad yet, but right there, he is sending one opposite field. That is a two-run shot, so now I have a five-run lead. Lou Brock, hard at ground ball to second base, wasn't able to get a base hit in his third at-bat, I believe that was, but still, five-run lead now, so this should be good, man. After that, I was planning on going the distance. Once I had a five-run lead, it was looking good. Unless this guy made it within, you know, maybe a three-run game or something, maybe I would have got the pen warming up, but Oswalt, no, this I didn't get too many strikeouts in this game, I don't think, but Oswalt was, you know, he wasn't really making good swings on the sinker. I found that when I was hanging sliders, and when I was, you know, leaving sinkers right over the middle of the plate, obviously he was making good swings, but when I was throwing inside sinkers and stuff, this guy really wasn't making that good swings, just getting jammed like he did right there with Upton. And he was just making good swings on, like, sliders and changeups and just off-speed pitches. But the sinker, man, once the fifth inning rolled around, I just realized this guy wasn't really capitalizing on the sinker and stuff on the inside part of the plate. So I was giving this guy some more sinkers. He's just flying out to end the inning. So, I mean, now it's late in the game, man. It's the bottom of the sixth inning. Oswalt is still in, like I was saying. Wasn't going to take him out with a good lead like this. He puts in a lefty. which I figured he would do because I think I have all the lefties in the lineup at the moment are doing damage 100%, and Oswalt is he's getting a base hit on the board too, so he is doing something for the squad as well. He wants in on the hitting frenzy, man. Ben Revere is back up, and he's getting his fourth base hit of the game. Too bad Oswalt doesn't have any speed, or I would have tried to get Revere another RBI in the process. So now Brantley is in. I don't know why the game does this, man. When somebody is on third base and you hit a weak chopper right back to the pitcher or something, he'll just take off. He'll just take off for home, and that's what happened right there. Obviously, with Oswalt, he doesn't have the best speed, so I didn't have a chance in hell of getting back to third base. But it's all good. Still have a really good lead in this game. Arenado just hitting a weak fly ball to right field, not testing it, even though I got that speed on second base. So now, Eddie Matthews, since he's been heating up lately, I figured he was going to do something clutch in this situation, but he wasn't. But, you know, still a 7-2 ball game going to the top of the seventh inning. This guy needs to get something going and fast. But first guy coming to the plate in this inning is just hitting a ground ball to Lindor at second base. So he is going down fairly quickly. So now Gary Sanchez is in once again. Sanchez doesn't seem to, I don't think he had much going on in this game. It seems like everyone, not everyone, but a lot of people, when they use silver catchers, they're using the Sanchez. I mean, I'd rather use Molina, to be honest. And Sanchez is going down looking on the up-and-away sinker right there. Look at this. You know everything is going my way when check swings are getting called swings. So I'm able to get another K with Oswalt. Victor Martinez, have a game, young fella. Have a game. That's his second home run of the day. This could possibly be the breakout game for Victor Martinez. The squad had a very good game. This guy decides to leave. Oswalt had a very solid outing. As always, guys, if you enjoyed, leave a thumbs up. I will see everybody in the next video.